Men's Basketball Weekly Update with Head Coach TJ Otzelberger. It's a recap of the games from last week. The first one against Denver, a 78-66 win. That game, you know, you pulled away for a little bit, but never that comfortable 20-point or bigger lead. They have a lot of talent that gave you some fits at times. They made some shots. They haven't quite put it together, but you got the win. Jenkins and Flatten were really kind of sensational from three-point land. Recap that win for us.
Yeah, I think with Denver, very talented team. They've got some graduate transfers. They're still kind of trying to hit stride. They've had some injuries early in the year, which have posed some challenges. But they're a group that, you know, as the year goes on, they're going to get better once they get used to playing together. So coming in here, we saw signs of their talent and ability and what they can be. We also saw some signs that at times they're not all on the same page. And so really, to play the way we did, I thought the ball moved great, especially in the first half. Skyler and David, you mentioned, really knocked down shots. I thought Tevin, Owen, Alex really moved the basketball great for us. And so we're never able to take it to that next level, get it at the 20-point mark, but we're in control of that game from pretty much from start to finish, and we're able to finish the job.
Saturday, game two of a doubleheader, the Lamb Bonanza. A great crowd on hand. That first half really attacked that zone, that 1-3-1 or 1-1-3, however you want to classify it. But Dom had a very good game, 37 points, and you really limited Nezaquezi in that first half and kind of set the tone for how the rest of that game played out.
I thought our guys did a great job sharing the basketball, especially early. We had great push and transition. Ball kept moving. We got Mike some touches in there. Had 51 points at the break. I think that was attributed to our guys' unselfishness, looking for each other. And then, like you mentioned, Alex Aarons did a tremendous job on Nezaquezi. I think he had two at the half, and Alex really prevented his touches, a guy who's been averaging in the 20s in league play. So as the game moved on, I thought there were stretches where our offense hit a little bit of a lull. It's still challenging when you're up by 15, 18 to keep your foot on the gas. We've got to get better at doing that. But overall, happy with our guys. Great team win and excited to come out with a victory.
After struggling last week with the defense, how would you grade how they performed last week coming off of, you know, that game against Fort Wayne and then playing the zone against South Dakota?
Well, I think if you look at four of the five league games, we've held our opponent under 66 or less, 66 being the Denver game. And so when our opponents have been held to that point, we've had a great margin for victory. So if our focus on that end of the floor can be to get stops, help us get going in transition, I think we'll be in great shape. And that was certainly the case in the USD game, where it was more of a zone defense, as well as the Denver and the Oral Roberts were playing man-to-man.
Got the one game this week, head up to Grand Forks on Wednesday to play the Fighting Hawks. They're a team that's, you know, maybe a little up and down so far this year. They're 2-3 in league play. 10 players average 10 points per game or more for them. And then Avance is their leading scorer. Scout the Fighting Hawks for us.
Well, they've got a veteran team. Avance is their go-to guy on the block. He's right at 16, 17 points a game. He can really score it in there. He understands angles. Undersized post player, but really a blue-collar, hard-working player. And then they've got some veteran players around him. Cortez Seals, he's been with the program and a guy who can really get to the basket. They've got Billy Brown, guard, who's really stepped up shooting it well for him. Marlon Stewart, transfer from Creighton. I mean, he can play the one. He can knock down shots and make plays. So veteran group, a team that they share the ball. When they can get a rhythm offensively, especially in transition, they can be really good. So our focus is going to have to be to get back, get our defense set, and make sure we keep them out of the paint.